Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Today we will be doing the second part of the chapter, A Horse and Two Goats, which is written by R.K. Narayan. In the last class, we came to know that Muni was a very old man, a villager who was very poor also, and he did not get the drumstick curry. And he was very sad. He decided to go and take his goats to graze and sit there till evening. And then he would come back and his wife will give him something to eat. Now we come to the next part. First, we will see a nice and funny picture that will summarize what we are going to do today. See, here is a gentleman. We can understand that maybe this person is a very rich man and maybe an American. Okay, a foreigner, and here let us assume that this is Muni, a very old man, and he is sitting on the pedestal below the statue, and suddenly these two people meet one another. Now the problem is, we came to know in the last class only that Muni saw a strange looking car, and that stopped suddenly in the middle of the road, and the man came running to Muni asking about something, about the gas station, about the petrol pump. But suddenly he looks at the statue and he was so amazed that he comes running to Muni asking about the, decided, he had already decided to ask him about the statue. But Muni becomes extremely afraid because this person's pant was a khaki pant. It was a style, you know, we often wear khaki like soldiers. We wear pants like that. So he was also wearing the khaki pant, and normally a villager does not know about that kind of a style. So he thought that this person must be some soldier or some policeman. So he became very afraid. Now the problem is, both of them cannot communicate with one another. Why? Because the American knows only English, does not know Tamil, and this old man who lives in Kritam knows only Tamil and not English. So if you do not have a common language, how can we talk? For example, if I know Bengali and you know English and we don't know any other language other than that, we don't have a common language, we cannot talk, isn't it? We can just do gestures, we can wave our hand or make some faces. Other than that, we cannot communicate. So let's see what happens when they start communicating or they start trying to talk to one another. Let's see what happens. Okay, so the red-faced man was wearing khaki clothes. That means clothes that was, I already told you that it is a common style. We wear soldier-like pants. The stripes are quite like the soldiers. And that is a common style nowadays. But this old man did not know anything about that style. Now, the red-faced man was wearing a pant like that, evidently a policeman or a soldier. So what did Muni feel? Muni felt that this person must be a policeman or a soldier, and he looked like a policeman. Why? Because he was wearing a khaki pant. Muni said to himself, he will chase or shoot if I start running. So Muni was afraid. Muni thought that I should start running, I should get away from this place. But then he also thought that if I suddenly started running, then he might start chasing me. He might think that I have done something wrong and that is why I am running. If you run from the teacher, then even if you have not done anything wrong, if the teacher sees you suddenly running down the corridor, then she will be thinking that you must have done something wrong. So that is why it is better not to run. Some dogs chase only those who run. Oh Shiva, protect me. So he thinks that if I run, then also he will think that I have done something wrong. If I do not run, then also this policeman is coming towards me and soon he will arrest me and take me to the police station. So hey Lord Shiva, please protect me. Okay, I don't know why this man should be after me, but the old man could not understand. He's a very old man. He has done no harm to anybody. Now he cannot understand, why is this policeman at the back of him? Why is he chasing the old man? What has he done? Meanwhile, the foreigner cried, marvelous, again nodding his head. Now, why is this foreigner saying this word marvelous? Because he is still looking at the statue and the statue is so beautiful to him. He is amazed, and that is why he goes on commenting about the statue. He paced around the statue. What do you mean by paced? Paced around the statue means he just moved around the statue. He walked around the statue with his eyes fixed on it. He cannot move his eyes from that direction. He is so amazed. He is so awestruck by the beauty of the statue. He cannot just move his eyes from it. Muni sat frozen. Why frozen? When you are very afraid, you are like, you cannot move yourself. He sits frozen over there because he is afraid. Immediately, this policeman is going to catch him. And then for a while, he sits frozen and then fidgeted. Fidgeted means he moves uneasily and tried to edge away. Now he has finally decided it is better to run. Now the other man suddenly pressed his palms together, smiled and said, "Namaste, how do you do?" Now that American, that foreigner had gone all round the statue. He has seen the statue and now he has come again in front of the old man. He suddenly remembers that he was talking to the old man. He wanted to talk to the old man. So he says, "Namaste, how are you?" Next, at which Muni spoke the only English expressions he had learnt. He knew only two words. What were those words? Only two English words was there in his vocabulary. He only knew two English words and he said both of them. Having exhausted his English vocabulary, that means he knows no other English words. So how is he going to talk with this policeman who is speaking in English? He started in Tamil. So he continues the rest of the communication in Tamil, which the American cannot understand. What does he say in Tamil? "My name is Muni. These two goats are mine." So, you know, these two goats, these are mine. And no one can gainsay it. No one can say that these goats are not mine. No one can deny it. Gainsay means deny. No one can deny that these are my goats. Though our village is full of slanderers. Slanderers means people who often tries to speak false, speak untrue facts, isn't it? Often lie about other people. There are a number of people who can tell you, can lie to you, but who will not hesitate to say that what belongs to a man doesn't belong to him. So he goes on saying that, you know, "I am Muni. I have these two goats, these are my goats. Nobody can gainsay it. Nobody can deny that. But obviously, there are few bad people in the society who might say that these goats are not Muni's. But actually, these are mine." Why does he say it? So that the policeman cannot claim that Muni is a thief. Okay. Next paragraph. The foreigner faithfully looked in the direction indicated by Muni's fingers. Muni was doing gestures. Muni was showing, pointing at his village. At the far away direction, okay, with his fingers. So when he was pointing at the village, the foreigner looked that side again, gazed for a while, that is looked for a while at the two goats and the rocks, and with a puzzled expression took out his silver cigarette case and lit a cigarette. Now he wanted to understand what this old man was saying but could not understand anything. So he was trying to understand through his gestures. When Muni was pointing at the village, when Muni was pointing at the goats, telling that these goats are mine, okay, he was trying to understand that, but he could not, the foreigner even could not understand the gestures, okay. So he decides to stop thinking about that and he lights a cigarette. He thought of smoking a cigarette. Suddenly, remembering the curtsies of the season, he asked, "Do you smoke?" Now he thinks that, okay, I cannot smoke just on my own. I should offer it to the other person also. That is a normal courtesy. That is a polite form of behavior. That when there is another person, you offer whatever you are having. If you are having a chocolate, you offer it to that person also. So he says that, okay, let me offer a cigarette to Muni also. So he asks, "Do you smoke?" Now, let us, before moving to the next part, see what this khaki pant is. This is the khaki pant. Normally, soldiers wear it and that is why Muni was afraid. Okay. Next, this is the lighter. Okay, we will be talking about the lighter now. What happens here? So, the soldier, that American, that foreigner asks him, "Do you smoke?" So, Muni says again those two words. Whereupon, the red-faced man took a cigarette and gave it to Muni. Naturally, he could not understand whether Muni will smoke or will not smoke because he has said what? Yes, no, both. Isn't it? So, he decides to give one cigarette to Muni, who received it with surprise, having had no offer of smoke from anyone for years now. So, he has been never offered, okay, a cigarette. because he is very poor, he cannot buy a cigarette. So there is nobody who will offer a cigarette to him, isn't it? Cigarette is costly for villagers. Villagers normally have those bidi and all that. Those are cheaper ones. So he is amazed that, oh my God, this person is giving me a cigarette. He had always wanted to smoke a cigarette. Only once did the shopman give him one on credit, and he remembered how good it had tasted. Again, he's talking about that shopkeeper. That shopkeeper had once given him one cigarette free of cost. So that time he had smoked one cigarette and he had liked the taste of it, and now he is getting another one. So he's very happy. The other flicked the lighter open and offered a light to Muni. Now, the American is a very rich one, isn't it? So, he has a lighter with him. You know, the lighter which you use to burn a cigarette. So, that one. Muni felt so confused about how to act that he blew on it and put it out. Now, what happens? Let us see the picture. Now, this is the lighter. Okay. The American has lighted this one and has offered it to Muni so that he can light his cigarette from this lighter. But what did Muni do? Muni has never seen a lighter in his life. So he did not know what to do with that fire. So what did he do? He just puffed it. He just blew it out. This was the lighter with the flame on, and Muni just blew on it and the fire was gone. Okay. Next, see what happens. The other puzzled. Now, obviously, the American has never seen such a thing happening. Okay, normally what happens is when somebody offers you the lighter to light your cigarette, you just light it from there directly. But he has never seen somebody blowing the lighter off, isn't it? So he was puzzled, but undaunted. But he thought that, okay, fine, no problem. He was courageous, flourished the lighter, that is, he presented the lighter again and lit Muni's cigarette. Now he himself lights the cigarette of Muni. Muni drew a deep puff and started coughing. It was racking. Racking means it was painful, no doubt, but extremely pleasant. Now, Muni was smoking a cigarette after a long time. So, he was not used to, he did not have a habit of smoking. So, he started coughing. Okay. It was very bad. It was a very painful cough. When his cough subsided, that means when his cough finally calmed down or became a little less severe, he wiped his eyes and took stock of the situation, understanding that the other man was not an inquisitor of any kind. So he feels that, okay, a policeman who has come to arrest him will obviously not give him a cigarette, isn't it? So this man meant no harm to me. This man was not trying to do any harm to me. Okay, then I'm safe. So he starts talking. Yet, in order to make sure, he remained wary. But he remained cautious. You know, he knew that if anything wrong happens or if any problem arises, he will surely run. He is cautious, but he is also okay with the situation because he understands that he is not in danger because the policeman has offered him a cigarette. He is happy. No need to run away from a man who gave him such a potent smoke. The person has given him such a potent smoke, such a strong, nice smoke. So there is no need to be afraid of somebody, so good a man, isn't it? His head was reeling. That means his head was dizzy. He was feeling dizzy from the effect of one of those strong American cigarettes made with roasted tobacco. The man said, I come from... Now the man has started talking, but he is talking in what? Is he talking in Tamil? No. He is talking in English. And can Muni understand it? No. He cannot understand anything. What does the American say? I have come from New York. He took out a wallet from his hip pocket and presented his card. Now, this is another funny incident. Now, normally we have our cards. No, we carry it. We show it as our identity. What do we do? What is our name? It is written in that card. Okay. So, the American shows his card to Muni. He wanted to show who he was. But what did Muni understand from it? Muni felt that this is the warrant. Okay. Muni felt that this is the warrant and this is actually the policeman who has come to arrest him. Okay, normally policemen show the warrant and then he can take you to jail. So this must be the warrant. Beware of khaki, one part of his mind warned. Again, he started thinking that no, I have to be aware. This person is showing the warrant. He can take me to jail. Take all the cigarettes or whatever is offered, but don't get caught. Okay, so take whatever the policeman is giving you, but be careful. Don't get caught. Beware of khaki. He wished he were in 70, as the shopman had said. At 70, one did not run, but surrender to whatever came. So now he feels sorry that I have become so old. I'm 70 years old. The shopkeeper said that I'm 70. And when you are young, you can run. But at the age of 70, nobody can run. So even if the police tries to catch me, I cannot escape. I will be caught. He could only ward off trouble by talk. So he decided to keep trouble away by talking. But how will he talk without a common language? So he went on. All in chest. Chest means pure Tamil. He's speaking in Tamil, which the American can understand, for which Kritam was famous. So Kritam was famous because all the people of Kritam talked in pure Tamil. He said, so what is he talking? This part, such a big part, all he's speaking in Tamil, which the American cannot understand. He said, before God, Sir Bhagwan, who sees everything, I tell you, sir, that we know nothing of the case. Now this paragraph can be quoted and can be asked that what case is being talked about here. What has happened is, if the murder was committed, whoever did it will not escape. Bhagwan is all seeing. Don't ask me about it. I know nothing. Now the actual situation, the narrator is telling us about the crime or the case. What is the case? A body had been found mutilated. Mutilated means a destroyed, disfigured body was found. Where was the body found? Under a tamarind tree. What is a tamarind tree? A tamarind tree is in Bengali we call it Tetul Gach, or in Hindi we call it Imli. Okay. Under that tree, a destroyed, disfigured body was found at the border between Kritam and Kuppam. So let us assume that this is Kritam, this is one village, and this is the other village. Okay. And between at the border of these two villages, we have that mutilated, that disfigured body. That disfigured body was found at the border of the two villages, Kritam and Kuppam, a few weeks before. And that is why Muni thought that perhaps this policeman has come here to arrest me, thinking that I had committed the murder or I had killed that person. And that is why the policeman has come here and he is showing me the warrant. Giving rise to much gossip and speculation. Speculation means people had normally a small village like Kritam or Kuppam. Normally these kind of incidents does not happen. Okay, so suddenly there is a mutilated body found. So people are thinking, people are talking about it, gossiping about it. Muni added an explanation. Anything is possible here. People over there will stop at nothing. The foreigner nodded his head and listened courteously that he understood, though he understood nothing. He understands nothing, but because the other man is talking so much, he is listening, but understanding nothing. Okay. I am sure you know when this horse was made, said the red man, smiling ingratiatingly. So he smiled in a very flattering way, asking, do you know when this horse was made? Obviously, you must be knowing it. You are sitting below the horse. You must be knowing about the horse also. Now, that American is bothered about the horse and nothing about anything else. Okay. Muni reacted to the relaxed atmosphere by smiling. So the policeman, he thought that the policeman was smiling now. So there is no need to be afraid. So he says in a very chaste Tamil, what does he say? Please go away, sir. I know nothing. I promise we will hold him for you if you see any bad character around. We will bury him to his neck in a coconut pit. What is a coconut pit? We will see this. A picture we will see. If he tries to escape. But our village has always had a clean record. Must definitely be the other village. So he goes on saying, please go away, sir. Please leave me alone. If any bad person is seen around, okay, if I see anybody over here who might have committed that crime, then I will surely, what will I do? I will bury him in a coconut pit. You know, in the South Indian villages, there are lots and lots of coconut trees. Now, you must have seen all these peels of coconut, isn't it? The coconut stays inside this part. Okay. So, now what will we do with this? All the leftover part of the coconut. So, these are kept or these are, accumulated in a particular place. They often dig up a part of the soil and then keep all these coconut leftovers over there. So, he says, now that it is a heaped it is a huge heap of coconut, you can understand. All these coconuts are thrown in this place. So he says, if I find that murderer, then I will put him inside this. I will bury him inside this pit. As in, he was trying to punish. Okay. So he says, again he says that, yet I will tell you, sir, normally Pritam is a very good village. People of Pritam does not do such a crime. It must be that other village, that is Kuppam, who has done the crime. Now the red man implored. Now the red man is frustrated. He is going on talking. He is going on expressing his feelings to the old man, but he could not understand. He is speaking in Tamil. Now he implored, means he begs. Please, please, I will speak slowly. Please try to understand me. Can't you understand even a simple word of English? Everyone in this country seems to know English. I have gotten along with English everywhere in this country, but you don't speak it. So this man has visited all the other, maybe he has gone only to the cities. People in the cities can talk a bit of English, but a village or in a village like Pritam, which is where there is not much education and mainly English spoken, people are very less over here. And Muni does not know even a bit of English. So he says that wherever I went, everybody could speak English. But you are not speaking in English. What is your problem? Have you any religious or spiritual scruples against English speaking, English speech? What do you mean by scruple? Scruple means hesitation. Sometimes we, our religion holds us back from certain things. For example, maybe in one religion it is said that if you go to some other country, then it is a wrongdoing according to your religion. Okay, you should not do that if you are of this religion. If you are of that religion, you should not do this. So there must be some scruples, there must be some hesitations. Maybe according to your religion, you are not allowed to speak English. Is it that? That is why you are not speaking English. What is the problem? Why are you not communicating in English? Muni made some indistinct sounds. Now, he did not know what to say. So, he just makes a bit of sound in his throat and shook his head. Encouraged. Now, what did the other man think? The foreigner thought that, okay, Muni is understanding now. The other went on to explain at length, uttering each syllable with care and deliberation. What do you mean by syllable? Syllable means when you break the words into small, small parts. For example, if I have to say elephant, I just don't say elephant. I say elephant. I'm breaking it and saying it slowly so that the other person can understand. It is easier for the other person to understand. Now he is talking slowly so that Muni can understand what he is speaking with a lot of care and deliberation. Presently he sidled. Siddle means he just walks and comes to the side of the old man. That is, he also now sits on the pedestal beside Muni, explaining, you see, last August, now the foreigner is telling his own story, okay, how he came to India. You see, last August, we probably had the hottest summer in history. It was very hot in New York, okay, and I was working in short sleeves in my office. So I was wearing, long sleeved dress, and it was very hot. I was at the 40th floor, 40. It was at the 40th floor of the Empire State Building. It was extremely hot, and we had a power failure one day. So one day there was a, power cut. There was load shedding, and then I was stuck for 4 hours. So 4 hours he was stuck at the 40th floor. He could not come down because the lift was also not working. The elevator was not working. The air condition was not working. The AC was not working. So it was very hot, and he could not come down the building. All the way in the train, I kept thinking, and the minute I reached home in Connecticut, so where did he stay? He stayed in Connecticut. What was his wife's name? His wife's name was Ruth. We will visit India this winter. It's time to look at other civilizations. So when he came back, he told his wife that, okay, I have understood that it is time that we go to the other places, go to the other countries and see how they survive that extreme heat. Okay, normally in America it is not that hot, but in the other countries like India it is very hot. So he decided to check how Indians survive in the summers. It is very hot in summer in India, so he wanted to see how they survived in summer in India. So now what happens? Next day, she called the travel agent first thing and told him to fix it, and so here I am. Ruth came with me but is staying back at Srinagar. So Ruth, his wife, was at Srinagar, and I'm the one doing the rounds and joining her later. So he decided to roam around and go to the other states also. And so he has come to this part of South India. Muni looked reflective at the end of this long oration and said rather feebly, "Yes, no," as a concession. So again, the same thing. He did not understand anything. So he just had to say yes, no again to the other's language. And now he continues in Tamil. "When I was this high," he indicated a foot high. Let us see one image which will show you. See, when we say that we are very small, we often do this kind of a gesture with our hand. That when we are this small, then my grandfather had told me that he was trying to say something. Okay, but he did not finish. I had heard my uncle say, he was trying to say, but he could not finish that. Immediately, the American starts speaking again. No one can tell what he was planning to say, as the other interrupted him means stopped him and continued to speak. Now, the American has stopped Muni and he goes on speaking. What does he say? "Boy, what is the secret of your teeth? How old are you?" Now, suddenly, the American sees Muni's teeth. Muni has almost no teeth, isn't it? All the teeth have fallen off because he's a very old man. So he says, "Oh my God, dear boy, how old are you? What happened to your teeth?" Muni forgot what he had started to say and remarked. Sometimes we too, just imagine somebody is talking about his teeth, and what did Muni reply? Muni says, sometimes what happens is we often lose our cattle, the sheep and the goats that we have. We often lose them. How? Jackals or cheetahs sometimes eat them away, okay? But sometimes it is theft. Sometimes there are people who steal our sheep and goats. Over in the next village, so people from the next village, thieves from the other villages come in and steal our cattle, our goats and our sheep and everything. Why is he saying this? We do not know. We do not know why one person is saying this and why the other person is saying that. Okay, nobody understands anything here. Okay, and then we will know who has done it. But, you know, whenever a crime is committed, whenever there is a stealing or whenever there is a theft in our village, we know, we surely come to know who has done it. How? Our priest at the temple can see in the camphor flame. Camphor flame, you already know camphor in Bengal, it is called Korpul. So that is present in the temple. So when you light that camphor, in that flame of the camphor, you can see the face of the thief. Just imagine. This is a belief. Obviously, you cannot see the face, isn't it? So they believe that in the camphor flame, the priest can see the face of the thief. And then obviously he is caught. If you can see the culprit, you will catch him. So the priest sees the culprit and catches him. He gestured with his hands, a perfect mincing of meat. What do you mean by mincing? Mincing means cutting. This is the gesture which you do when you try to show that you are cutting something, isn't it? So he makes a gesture like this. What was he trying to say? He tries to say that when the thief is found, then we just cut him like this. That means we punish him a lot. Now, what did the American understand? The American can only understand the gestures. What did the American interpret? The American watched his hands intently. Intently means he watches him very carefully and feels that the old man wanted to chop something or cut something. That is why he was showing that expression. He was gesturing in that way with his hands. Okay. "Maybe I'm holding you up and you want to chop wood." So he thinks that perhaps Muni had come to this place to chop wood or to cut pieces of wood. But because the American has come, he cannot do it. So he decides to help Muni. Okay. "Where is your axe? You tell me. Hand it to me and show me what to chop. You just tell me what I have to chop. I will cut the wood for you." "I do enjoy it. You know, just a hobby. We get a lot of driftwood." What is driftwood? Driftwood means pieces of wood which float down the river. Okay, sometimes what happens is the pieces of wood is transported through the river. How? By the current of the river, the logs come from one place to the other. Now, as the log is moving, it often gets stuck to the sides of the river. So in that driftwood, there was a river beside his house. That means beside whose house? Beside the American's house. So in that river, often driftwoods were found. That is, pieces of woods were found in the river water. So what did I do? On Sundays, I do nothing but chop wood for the fireplace. Now, you know, in the winter, in the places where there is a very extreme cold in the winter season, they often chop woods and use it in their fireplace to get a beautiful beautiful light as well as warmth in the room. Okay, so he cuts the pieces of wood and uses it into the fire for the fireplace. I really feel different when I watch the fire in the fireplace, although it may take all the sections of the Sunday New York Times to get the fire started. So obviously, I have to work a lot. I have to give a lot of effort. Why? Because these wood pieces are soaked in water, isn't it? So you have to dry the woods and only then you can light the woods, isn't it? You can burn the woods only when the woods are dried up. Now, these are wet woods soaked with water. So it is very difficult to burn it. But still, I find it very nice when the fireplace looks nice. Okay, Muni felt totally confused but decided the best thing would be to make an attempt to get away from this place. He again decides to run away. He tried to edge out. He tried to move out again, saying, "Must go home," and turn to go. So he says that I must go home and try to run away from there. The other seized his shoulder and said, desperately, now he is desperate. He is seriously desperate. "Is there no one, absolutely no one here to translate for me? Who can translate?" Translate is a person. Translator is a person who can translate from one language to the other language. If there is a translator, then the foreigner could explain to Muni what he is trying to say. Otherwise, Muni cannot understand what the American is saying. He looked up and down the road, which was deserted. Deserted means there was nobody on the road in this hot afternoon. The stranger almost pinioned. What do you mean by pinioned? Pinioned means he almost held him very tightly and he had pushed him to the statue. Muni's back to the statue. Muni was pinioned or pinned to the statue. Like you pin a paper to the soft board like that. He was pushed to the statue. "Isn't this statue yours? Why don't you sell it to me?" Now, this is the real intention of the foreigner. He wants to buy the statue. Okay. The old man now understood the reference to the horse. Thought for a second. Now, the American was pointing at the horse. Now, the old man feels that, okay, now the American is trying to talk about the statue. And said in his own language. Now, he again starts speaking in Tamil. "I was an urchin." That means I was a very small boy. This high, excuse me. "When I heard my grandfather explain this horse and warrior, and my grandfather himself was this high when he heard his grandfather, whose grandfather?" Now he's talking about this horse. He says that when I was very small, then my grandfather told me about this horse. Okay. "And when my grandfather was again small, then he had come to know from his grandfather." So what has happened? The information about this statue and about the warrior, about this horse and the warrior, this he came to know from his ancestors, from his grandfathers and from their grandfathers. Okay. So he says this to the American. The other man interrupted him again. Now the other man stops him and again starts speaking. So we will keep up to this in the next class again. We will do the last part of the chapter. I hope you have understood the chapter. It is easy. And if you have liked the video, then you please comment and subscribe. And if you require any other chapter to be explained, you also write it. Thank you so much. That's all for today.